Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today is an integration video between Fibaro and Thuya Smart Life devices. On the left is the virtual device that I have created for integration with Thuya devices. On the right is the Thuya Smart Life app. So if you're already having some Thuya devices, you might know this app already. So on the right side, I have one socket which I've integrated. So this integration is two-way, so I can turn on and turn off from my Smart Life app, which shows on the Fibaro system, and I can control from the Fibaro system also. So that's the integration that we are going into today. So let's get into the integration. So for the prerequisites, you need three things. That is, you need the Fibaro home center, then you need Thuya devices. You must have it configured it on the Thuya Smart app or the Smart Life app, and of course you need a Node-RED instance that's going to be working like bridge. The first thing that you need to do is you have to get the list of IDs and keys using a procedure. That procedure you can have it from the description on this video. Just follow that procedure. The next thing is go into your Node-RED instance. You need to download a new type of node called Thuya. Just search for that and install this node. Next thing is, once you've installed it successfully, you can see it in the installed section. Yes, you can see that Thuya Smart Device node you have to install. So once that is done, on the list of nodes, just search for Thuya. You will see two specialized nodes for this. Take the first one, pick the first one and drag it. And so you must have had the list of devices already. Only two things need to be filled in, that is the ID and key. I'm just going to be showing you the integration for just a socket. So I'm pasting the name of the socket, then I'm pasting the ID and as well as the secret key. Yes, once they are keyed in, other parameters you don't have to change, just save it. Before we actually get into the integration, I want to show you what is the device structure, I mean the sorry message structure that you will be getting once you put it into Node-RED. So I'm just putting a debug node and I'm showing you the message it's getting. So you must have this connected thing, otherwise it's not working fine. You need to recheck your ID and key. If there's a mistake, you'll have that problem. So now I'm trying to toggle the socket from my Smart Life app. So this is the message structure that is getting generated from the debug node. So this is what is changing. So if I'm going to be turning on or turning off the socket, this value has changed, that is that 1: true or false. So this is what I need to send it to Fibaro virtual device. So for that I need to manipulate that data. So I took a function node, and turning off I'm getting false, for turning on I'm getting true. So this is what I need to manipulate. So we will take that message, and that message is passed on to the function node. Here I am going to be parsing those data. That is, instead of the regular message.payload, I'll be changing it into message.payload dot dps of 1. 1 is the it's the first element of that object. Yeah, and I'll change this one to message.payload. Okay, next I'll save it. So at the end of the function, my message.payload is either going to be true or false. So we'll put a switch. If message.payload is true, and if message.payload is false. If it is true or false, I'm going to handle it differently. So we'll stitch them together. So the output of the switch is, the first output is true, the second output is false. So we need to send this to Fibaro. Say we will take a HTTP node, HTTP request node. We'll need another one for the false condition. We'll copy paste. and we'll stitch them. So now all is fine in the Node-RED part. Now I need to create a virtual device in Fibaro. Let us log into the Fibaro and create a new virtual device. So I'm going to be making a very simple virtual device. Since it's just a socket, I need a label and two buttons. So let's give it a name, and if you want, you put it into some room. The IP address would be the IP address of your Node-RED, and the port number will be 1880 because that's where the Node-RED is running. So that will be the port number. Yes. So next we will go and add our label. Then we will add two buttons, one for on and one for switching it off. Yes. So this is done. So I'm just making the name meaningful. Coffee table is on or off, and the buttons I'm renaming it as on and off. We'll save this. So this is the label that this label is what we need to be changing from Node-RED. So just make a note of this ID because we'll need it in the HTTP request manipulation part. So now we will move on to the Node-RED. So here I'm going to be sending a HTTP request such that the label changes. So all these commands will be available in the video's description. You can take it from there. So this will turn it into on, and the other node will turn it into off. Let's save it and deploy the node. So I'm going to be toggling the status from my Smart Life app. I'm not showing it here, but I'm going to turn it. Yes, there's some error. Okay, the error was I missed out the data, so I changed it. Now I've redeployed and I'll try to, yeah, no errors. Good. So let's see. Okay, it is false and it is off here. Cool. Now once more I'll do another one check. I'll try to on the socket. Let's see if it gets turned on automatically. Yes, 1: true, and this is also on. Perfect. So now we have one way of communication, that is Tuya devices are sending information to Fibaro. The next thing is to turn on and turn off this device from Fibaro. So for this we need to put in a HTTP command. So I'm going to be creating get followed by slash coffee on followed by HTTP 1.1. next line we have to give host followed by the IP address of Node-RED and the port number. Let's copy paste the same thing onto the off also, and I'll change the URL alone. Instead of coffee on, I'll put it as coffee off. So I hope you get what I'm trying to do here. Whatever I'm given over here, I need to create corresponding endpoints in Node-RED also. So that will be the next step. I'm going to be creating endpoints. So same endpoint names, I should be using it over here also. So here it will be, I'll be giving it as coffee on. So whenever someone presses the on button of the virtual device in Fibaro, then the same thing gets conveyed over here to this endpoint node. Yes. So now I have established a way to communicate between Fibaro and Node-RED. So someone presses the button, it comes over here. So, but I don't want it in that form. Tuya requires it in some other form. So if you click on that Tuya smart node, so you can see on the documentation that this is the format it requires, the set documentation. This is what it requires. So I need to be doing some manipulation before I send the information to the smart node, Tuya smart node. So what kind of manipulation? You will need to look into the documentation. So this is the documentation. Search for set. Yes. So these are the options it requires. These are the input it requires for turning the light on and off in Tuya. So with a lot of searching and a lot of googling, a lot of forums, I've got the information, the message format. So I'm going to be pasting that in the function node. This is the format it requires. So set if it is true and set if it is false, that's going to turn on and turn off the devices. Save and join them all together, and let's make it a little bit neat looking. So this looks quite odd, so make it a little bit neat. Yes, so now we are done. Let's deploy and see whether all of it is working. Move on to I have just missed one small part. So after this I need I have to give to enter, then only it will work. This is the format for Fibaro. So once those two enter keys are pressed, yay, now it's working. Yes, so we have established the connection properly on both the ways. Turning on, my socket turned on, and the same is also, we can see it in those debug statements. Cool. So all of it is working fine. So once this is done, you can also remove those debugs also, this message debug nodes also, and you can deploy. So this is how we integrate. So I hope this is useful to you. Thank you for watching and do subscribe. Bye bye.